Hello, I'm Albert Maysles. I recently presented some of my early work at the Vinegar Hill Theater. It was a great success, and that's why we're committing it to a DVD at this time. In the development of direct cinema, as well as my new technique, indirect cinema, we had a lot of training along the way in different styles. So the first film we're going to present is an early just plain cinema film. It's called A Fish Market Fiasco. It stars Carl Preddy, Margaret Mola, and Tom Lucina. And here it is.
Fall in love with you. Do you think that you could love me too? Oh, then I should hold you and caress you. Would it impress you or distress you? Oh, then I should say for you I yearn. Would you think I'm speaking out of turn? And suppose that I declare it, would you take my love and share it? I'm not frozen, I'm in love with you.
So I hope you enjoyed A Fish Market Fiasco there. It was a good film for 1973, just getting started there. The next film is more of a cinema verite. It's made a year later in Richmond, Virginia, and it's entitled Amy Crehore at Her Locker. Here it is.
Kids again, playing hooky kids, late for school. Kids again, going barefoot down to the old swimming pool. Stealing pies and telling lies, like we all used to do. Sailing kites and having fights, and playing soldier too. Those memories all come back and make you feel blue. Memories that will follow you your whole life through. But now the sun is sinking, and in our hearts we're thinking just to be kids again.
Next up, we have a film I was quite proud of. It was an early effort to combine film noir with documentary. It's called A Night Mail. It's made in 1975. Here it is.
Thank you. But Bean Brothers had a dairy farm at Catlett's, and they'd had a row with a boy at work for him Saturday, and Sunday he burned down the barn, and I used that for a landmark to make the catch. And I was sitting on a stool on the door there, half asleep, waiting for that barn to show up, and the barn had burned down, and I missed the catch. You take leaving Lynchburg there on 29 at night, or leaving Washington with the Washington Post and Washington Heralds. You had to do local all along the way. Their people got the paper early in the morning. And dark or not dark, you had to get off at the right place.
A night mail, which involved the last mail train in the United States. Next up, we did an experiment combining the early direct cinema with film noir. It was called Direct Noir, and stars Peter Kleeman as the independent melodeon player. Here it is, the independent melodeon player.
Peter Kleeman on melodeon. Probably got it at a yard sale. I'm not really sure.
That was an independent melodeon player from 1985. Next is a segment from my latest cinematic philosophy. It's called Indirect Cinema. I've often wished I could do documentaries on people that are no longer with us. And this goes a long way towards that goal. This particular film is called A Visit with Mr. McIntire. Here it is. And that was my latest endeavor, a visit with Mr. McIntire. I hope you found it edifying. It's an example of the new up-and-coming cinematic philosophy, Indirect Cinema. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. And until we see you in the theater again, this is Albert Maysles wishing you good luck.